Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Media, here today with a video on the most common GM LS1 engine problems. The LS1 5.7 liter V8 engine was initially introduced in the 1997 C5 Corvette and found in a number of other GM vehicles through 2005, including the Pontiac Firebird GTO and Camaro SS. The engine offers up to 350 horsepower and 375 pound-feet of torque. There were some Holden models in Australia in which there were higher output variants of the LS1 back then. The LS1 was at the forefront and kind of began the modern-day LS craze. It is a lot of the reason we still to this day very commonly hear the terms just LS swap it thrown around. While the GM LS engines and the LS1 are often nearly synonymous with reliability and performance, these engines aren't completely bulletproof and still do have their fair share of common issues. So with that said, let's go ahead and jump in and discuss some of the most common LS1 engine problems. Number one on the list here, have a couple things lumped together, and that is high oil consumption, piston ring issues, and piston slap. Now, this all ties back into a technical service bulletin in which GM addressed this problem for 1999 through 2002 LS1 engines, in which high oil consumption was tied back into issues with the piston rings. And ultimately, on top of that high oil consumption, that could also lead to piston slap, as having wider tolerances or wider gaps between the piston rings and cylinder walls can actually allow the piston to move around and slap the side of the cylinder walls, which is known as piston slap. So a couple things there that kind of circulate around this high oil consumption and piston ring issues. Now, since GM did address this in a technical service bulletin back in the day, chances are a good number of these that were problematic from the factory were caught in the early days. However, sometimes things like high oil consumption and piston ring issues might not fully show themselves until higher mileage and on an older engine. So certainly a few of these likely did slip through the cracks and are still out on the roads today that have some of these piston ring issues. But again, still something to be aware of, since piston ring issues can be an expensive fix, since obviously that requires opening up the engine and replacing those rings and potentially the pistons. Moving on to the second most common problem, we have bent pushrods. Bent pushrods are really a very minor issue in the grand scheme. That is one of the benefits of these older school pushrod engines and overhead valve designs, is that they are very simplistic compared to a lot of more modern overhead cam or double overhead camshaft setups. So the bent pushrods are very easy to access, very easy to replace. Now, when it comes to bending the pushrods, a couple of the most common causes of this are over revving the engine, as well as upgrading the camshaft without addressing the pushrods. So the pushrods do become a noticeable weak point if you opt for too aggressive of a camshaft upgrade without addressing those pushrods and upgrading those. So something to consider if you are planning on revving the engine high frequently or upgrading the camshaft, definitely go ahead and address those pushrods. Otherwise, it really shouldn't cause any reliability or longevity concerns with the engine. Sometimes if you just have a minor bent pushrod, you might not even notice the symptoms at first. However, if the bend is serious enough or it continues getting worse, a couple of the symptoms to be on the lookout for include rough idle, poor performance, ticking sounds, and potentially the check engine light, depending on how serious the bent pushrod is. But otherwise, again, shouldn't cause any serious longevity or reliability concerns. Just pop in some new pushrods and you'll be back up and running and perfectly fine. Next on our list, the third most common problem is water pump failure. Now, this is also a very simple, straightforward problem and something that the LS1 isn't alone in here. A number of other LS engines do have issues with water pumps, and it's something that a lot of cars and engines suffer from, especially as they get older and higher mileage. The two most common causes of water pump failure on the LS1 engines are problems with the water pump shaft, which is a little bit more serious since that can cause a loss of coolant flow or significantly reduce coolant flow, which can lead to overheating and essentially leave you stranded. However, by far the most common issue with the water pumps is simply the water pump gaskets leaking coolant. This is a very minor issue. Usually these leaks start off very small and won't leave you stranded or cause any serious issues, but if you notice a leaking water pump from the gaskets, best to still go ahead and knock out that repair and get it taken care of as soon as possible. Fortunately, those gaskets are very cheap, about 10, 20 bucks, and if you are able to DIY that, ultimately it's a very cheap and simple repair job to knock out the water pump issues. So again, pretty minor issue in the grand scheme, just important to pay attention to if your water pump does fail again from the shaft or the impeller, that you could end up very rapidly overheating the engine, which would leave you stranded and necessitate towing the vehicle back home or to a repair shop. Moving on to our fourth and final common problem for the GM LS1 engine, we have oil pump issues. Most of this video hasn't been in any specific order. However, oil pump issues are definitely one of the less common problems with the LS1. And there are a couple different things to break down here with oil pump and oiling problems on the LS1 engine. So a few of those things are, number one, the LS1 pumps and a lot of LS oil pumps in general are known to suffer from cavitation issues at higher RPM. So with the LS1 pump, especially above about 6,200 RPMs, the pump starts suffering from cavitation. So if you're planning to do some sort of high revving, high performance build, then it's definitely something to address with the oil pump due to those cavitation issues. The second factor is the 97 and 98 LS1 oil pumps are notoriously weak. So if you have one of those earlier model LS1 engines, that's something that you'll want to consider there as well. And then lastly, actual failures or issues with the pump don't boil down to the pump itself, but instead typically revolve around the piston on the bypass valve. And so that's the biggest thing to look out for with oiling issues on the LS1 engine. Ultimately, when LS1 engines have really serious failures or catastrophic issues, a lot of the times it does boil down to these oiling issues. So again, if you're looking to do a high performance build, high revving build, anything of that nature, definitely go ahead and address those oiling issues and address the oil pump to ensure that you don't have a catastrophic failure with the oil pump. So really that wraps up the four most common problems for the GM LS1 engine. In summary of the problems and overall reliability, the LS1 engines, as with again most of the LS engines in general, is a very reliable engine but still prone to its share of common issues and faults. First were the piston ring issues on those 1999 to 2002 models, which GM addressed with the technical service bulletin, so it should be a relatively minor and uncommon issue nowadays. Then I talked about bent pushrods and water pump failures, both of which are pretty minor issues in the grand scheme, both pretty inexpensive and simple, cheap fixes, especially if you're able to DIY those jobs and knock it out without any labor charges. And then lastly, the LS1 is known to suffer from some oiling issues, so something to address if you're planning to really push the engine hard or do some sort of high performance build. Otherwise, the oiling issues are somewhat of a non-issue if you're just looking to daily drive the LS1 and not do anything too crazy with it. And then last note about the LS engines and the LS1, these are very popular, well-known, understood engines. So there are proven long-term effective solutions and a lot of information and knowledge out there about these engines and problems. So fortunately, if you do run into any of these issues with the LS1, there's tons of information out there to get the repair knocked out and come up with some long-term fixes to prevent those issues from happening again. Anyway, guys, that wraps up our video for today. If you appreciated the content, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and stay tuned for more in the future. Thanks, everyone.